Hello everybody, my name is Faethodas, welcome to this video. In this video I'm going to tell you about a new feature, something like a feature, in the Ragnarok expansion. Well, this, let's call it feature, gives us the chance to find the items that we are currently using on our characters to find the duplicates of these items, something like duplicates. So, how do we do that? First I will show you how to do that, and then I will tell you the results of farming about 50 times for this thing. First, this thing is happening by a Doppelganger character, enemy actually. This enemy spawns randomly, and not every time, in this maze here. This is the Mimer's Maze. This is an area in the Ragnarok expansion towards the end of the campaign in the Ragnarok, in the 5th act. And to get in this Mimer's Maze, we are in the area Yggdrasil Glade. And here we have to run all this way. Here is the not the last waypoint, but the one before that. This is the last. This is the Jotunheim waypoint. This waypoint is here in this area in the map. So we come to this waypoint, and then we run this way or that way. We go all of this way here, and we come here to the Mimer's Maze. So we go inside the Mimer's Maze. I'm going now to run through this whole area and to show you, maybe if we are lucky in this run we will find one or even better two Doppelganger enemies. Let me activate my skills. This is the epic difficulty, by the way. We can do this run in all three difficulties, but I came here on the epic difficulty for now. Let's go. We meet some enemies here. We kill them if we want. These enemies also are very badass, because when they explode, these magical flying ghosts, when they explode, they release a spellbreaker skill and they destroy our our skills. As you can see here, my skills are gone. I have to reactivate these skills again. So it is better these enemies to kill them from far away. Here we have more enemies, Mimer drones. Let's not try to kill everybody in this area. Also, we can find many coffers, containers and things like that, which is a good thing if you want to farm even more this area. You come here and farm some containers. More containers, we search through every corner, every corridor, every room in this Mimer's Maze. It is not a big maze, actually. Let's kill these guys, because they run behind me all the time. They do not let me go. There is an ancient chest here. They freeze me, they trap me, they do whatever they want with me, with my body. I am a slave to the pervert appetites. Okay, nothing here. We have some golems. More drones, more golems. Okay, so as we can see, up to this point, there is no Doppelganger. It seems that we are not very lucky this time. But this was only half of the maze. Now let's go to the other half. Maybe we can fight the Doppelganger here. These guys still are chasing us. They insist, they want to die, I guess. Nothing here, who cares about the containers? Let's kill these enemies here. They are dead, let's move on. What was that? Nothing. I am trapped again, but now everything is fine. Let's get inside this corridor. Nothing, only my FPS is going down. No Doppelgangers. Okay, that was nice, because we killed them with our elemental chaos attack of the elemental rage artifact. here we have one more majestic chest which was trapped. Thankfully I avoided this trap. Now here, can we fight here a doppelganger? No, we cannot. We cannot fight any doppelganger this time, in this run. And we move on, we try to fight, there are no doppelgangers. This is a very bad luck today. Come on you people, bring me a doppelganger. One doppelganger at least. I pick mechanical parts. I don't want these parts. And here we have nothing, a little bit more left to explore. Maybe we can find a doppelganger here in this small area, but I don't think so. Come on. Come on, a doppelganger, just one! Come on, come on, come on, come on. Nope! Nothing! Nothing! Too bad luck today! Very bad luck! Let me kill these enemies at least. Ouch! Ah! These enemies are very annoying because they destroy your skills and you have to reactivate your skills. Boom! Boom! Bam! Boom! Okay, so we have explored almost all of the maze. Let's go here. Nope. No doppelgangers. No doppelgangers. And this small area has some traps and some more golems. Okay, no doppelgangers. I'm not going inside through here because this is a boss room and the doppelganger never spawns inside this room. So, this is the Mimer's Maze. Usually the doppelganger spawns on this area here and most usually he spawns here and sometimes we fight it here. And most of the times this guy spawns in the first half of this maze, here in this area. Not here, but sometimes it spawns here or here or here, you never know. So, what is this guy all about? When we meet this guy, this is an enemy that comes out of the ground, and when it comes out, it is a doppelganger of our hero, which means he looks exactly like our hero. He is using the same items as our hero, exactly the same items. For example, if now we had a doppelganger spawned out, he would be using the same weapon, shield, helm, chest armor, gloves, and all of these things. These items would be exactly the same. Now, and when we kill this guy, this doppelganger, there is a very small chance, unfortunately, the chance is very small, to drop the items that he is using, which means that there is a small chance for him to drop this chest. And if he drops this chest, of course, we will have a duplicate, something like a duplicate item of this one. Because the items that drop from doppelganger are the same items, but the stats are different. The stats are not the same. But the item is the same. For example, if he was about to drop to the ground a chest armor, it would be this corselet of Freya, the set armor and nothing else. If he was to drop the shield, it would be the golden shield of Pelaron, but with different stat numbers. Or the helm would be the same, the golden Agris helmet, etc, etc. And this is a way, a good way to duplicate your items. If you have, for example, this item And you need absolutely to get one more of this item, to have two of the same item. And this item is very rare. You can come here in this Mimer's Maze and you can try to farm this Doppelganger enemy while you are using this item. You have to have this item equipped. So the Doppelganger, when he spawns out, he spawns by holding this specific item. And when you kill him, if you are super lucky, he may drop this item to the ground. Now, there is one thing to remember. Here, for example, we have this primary weapon setup. Here is the one, and we have a secondary setup. If, for example, we come here and we are using the primary setup, when the Doppelganger spawns, he will come out, he will be using this setup, the primary setup. But if we are using the secondary setup and he comes out, then he will be using the secondary setup. He will be using these two items and not these two. So this is an important thing to remember if we want to fight specific weapons or shields. We have to remember which weapon setup we are using, the first or the second. This is one detail, important detail. The other important detail is that when I was using this item here, these bracers, the Vatrahos bracers. As we can see, this item is mastery frequent, it has some stats on its own, but I did attach an epic primal magma. This is a charm. Once I fought this Doppelganger character, I killed him, and he dropped the Vatrahos bracers, as we can see here. Now, as we can see, the detail is that when he drops a green or mastery frequent item that we have attached an, a relic or a charm, he drops just the item, not the charm or the relic. So when this item dropped, it dropped without the primal magma, which means that as far as I understand, the Doppelganger is using just a copy of the items that we use, but with different stats and not with any relics or charms attached to it, to the items, if the items can have relics or charms. This is a very important detail to remember. So, after I have done about, let's say, 50 runs in this area, I did all the runs were made on both normal and epic difficulty. I faced this character about 2 or 3 times on legendary difficulty. The good thing about this one is that on normal difficulty you will fight this enemy at around he spawns at around level 49 to 52. On epic difficulty, he spawns around 69 to 73, and on legendary, he goes up to 84 level, 85. So, the best way to farm this item, this enemy, this character, is to go to normal difficulty, because it doesn't really matter for the which difficulty you kill him at, because every time he is using copy duplicates of your items. Let's call them duplicates. They are not exactly duplicates, because if to be duplicates they would need to have exactly the same stats, but anyway I call it duplicates. And even if you have finished the game on legendary difficulty and you go on normal and kill him on normal, he will still drop to the ground one of the items that you are using. So, and it is the fastest and easiest way to farm this enemy on normal, because on normal his level is much lower, and also the level of the enemies around in the maze is much lower, and you kill everybody bam boom, very very fast, and the farming goes faster this way. So, one more detail. There is a negative, actually two negative things here about this farming this enemy. One of the negative things is that this guy doesn't spawn every time you come to the Mimer's Maze. As you saw, we didn't fight this guy, we are on epic difficulty. I don't know if there are more chances on epic or legendary difficulty to spawn than in normal. I don't know about that. The bad thing is that it isn't a standard spawn. The good thing though is that many of the times that he did spawn, it was a double spawn, which means sometimes when you fight the doppelganger in this area, you will fight two doppelgangers instead of one. So for example, sometimes I was coming inside this thing, this maze, to farm this guy. I was fighting this guy somewhere around here. This is a usual place for him to spawn. I was killing him and then I was running through the rest of the maze trying to see if he would spawn again. And sometimes I found a second doppelganger in this area, usually maybe here or maybe somewhere around here. So this is a very good thing because let's say for example I did about 50 runs inside this maze overall, and about 20 times he didn't spawn at all, but from the 30 times that he did spawn, at least the half of the times it was a double spawn. So it means I did actually 50 runs and maybe I killed 50 doppelgangers. Although he didn't spawn about 20 times at all. This is a very good thing. And this is a great thing actually, I think. So overall, this is it for this guy, this Mimer's Maze. If you want to absolutely fight the copy of one of your items that you absolutely need to have a second one, a duplicate, then this is maybe a good way. And I say maybe because the second negative thing that I wanted to say is that he very rarely drops items to the ground. So I fought him about 50 times and I found only 3 items out of 50 battles. These 3 items are the 3 items that I found from this doppelganger character. The Vatrahos bracers, which came of course without the charm, which I was using, as I said before, because it does not spawn with charms. And also, another time, it dropped the Morbius the Ramrod, this weapon here, which I already use, of course. And one third time he dropped the Demon Skin Walkers. These 3 items dropped from this doppelganger character after about 50 kills. So this is the second negative thing. It is a very rare thing to drop items, but if you have free time to do it and if you have fun doing it and you absolutely need to duplicate some of your items, maybe this is a very good idea to come in this area and try to farm this guy. After all, many times he spawns, he has double doppelgangers spawning from the ground, and you kill 2 doppelgangers of your character, and it is a very good thing. But you have to be searching through the whole maze, which is not very big actually. If you have a good movement speed, sorry, you can do it very fast, especially on a normal difficulty with a character that has finished legendary difficulty. And also don't forget to go to your options menu, to general tab, game speed, and put the speed of the game to very fast if you want to run even faster through the game for farming even faster. So guys, this is it overall. These are the information that I have found so far about this, let's call it a feature. This is a very nice thing actually, that we get with the Ragnarok expansion. And it was a very nice surprise for me when I found out that this doppelganger can drop to the ground items that I'm using already on my character. So if you have any questions, leave a comment below, or if you have anything else to say, leave a comment below. I will reply as soon as possible, and I will see you very soon in more videos. Bye bye.